Καφέ Τσάρσον.
Hey guys, so today I'm going to show you what I eat in a day.
Hey, Fruit Bats, it's Frilly Banana Girl here. Welcome to another episode. So today's video is highly requested. It's a video on Cassie, I believe it is, or Casey from Blogilates. Firstly, I just want to say thank you to you little fruit bats who fly around YouTube, spreading the fruit seeds, tagging me in posts, trying to help others, coming back to me and letting me know who you feel needs my assistance. So today's video is about Cassie's diet. So she shared a day in the life of her eating, and it's a low calorie, low carb, high protein diet. So you know I've got a bit of a problem with that. And just a little disclaimer for those of you who want to cry about me making a video about someone else's diet. This is a health, fitness, and diet channel. That is what I talk about. If you don't like it, then I suggest you unsub and go fruit yourself hard today, because we are getting serious here about helping others. Alrighty, let's check out what Cassie eats for the day.
I always make sure to drink water in the morning, preferably with like a lemon or some type of fruit in there to really start up my metabolism and also so I'm not dehydrated.
First up, I wanted to say Cassie seems like a really sweet girl and the effort that she's put into videos is amazing. This is the first one I've seen and it's really good editing. So first up, she's having water and this is a fantastic start to the day, so I'm really happy to see this.
After that, one of my main meals that I love eating are the Blogilates banana pancakes. Now these are completely paleo. You just need one banana and two eggs, kind of blend it up, or if you don't have a blender, you can mush it up, but just make sure it's really smooth and put it on the pan at low, medium heat.
Ooh, what a combo bombo. Also, Cassie's having nearly 400 milligrams of cholesterol in those eggs for breakfast, so that she really needs to keep an eye on that. The banana is not ripe either. We need to wait till it's ripe and spotty, and bananas are actually not paleo. But I'm very happy to see that there's a banana in there. I just want to see another 8 or 9 at least. And that's only about 230 calories for that breakfast. Breakfast is a meal in particular that needs to be substantial, needs to start you on the right foot. So high carbohydrate, high calorie is where it's at. 230? No, we need a nice big smoothie of about 1,000 calories or more, ideally. So this sort of low carb, low calorie breakfast just sets you up for future binges and cravings throughout the day. So Cassie is also really active and has a busy social media life. So she definitely has to pay attention to how much carbohydrates and how much calories in general she is having.
When I get back, I'm kind of hungry. So I usually have a protein shake or some type of snack. So today we are making one of my staples, which is just a strawberry banana protein shake with some protein powder, one banana, some frozen strawberries, almond milk, a little bit of ice, and then you blend it up and that's it.
Was anyone else's stomach hurting as that unripe banana went in? Mine was, that's for sure. Ripe and spotty, Cassie.
Do you see how these are nice and ripe and spotty? That's how you want your banana. You do not want to eat starchy bananas or they will constipate you.
And it's a bit of fruit. I'm glad to see a bit of fruit, but just not enough. And protein powder in there, it's another combo of bombo. Almond milk is great. But we have another low energy, high protein meal here, which is about 330 calories.
So after I have my protein shake, I usually take a shower and change so that I'm fresh for the rest of the day. And then I'm checking email, designing stuff, taking phone calls, meetings, whatever it is. The day seriously feels nonstop. I usually have some type of a snack here. So today I'm having celery and hummus.
So as Cassie said, she is busy. This girl is busy, so she needs to keep an eye on her carb intake and make sure it's high because every cell in the body runs on glucose, and particularly the brain, which runs exclusively off glucose. So if we don't have enough, we are not going to feel our best. We're not going to be productive, and we're going to fall for the fatty food. And speaking of fatty foods, Cassie is into the hummus, which can be very, very fatty. So it's another low-carb dish.
For lunch, I usually have a salad. It really fills me up and I can put a ton of stuff on there. I am totally into seafood. So today I have romaine lettuce and spring greens along with imitation crab and shrimp right on top with a spritz of lemon. And my favorite dressing right now is Asian peanut vinaigrette from Trader Joe's. After a while, I get hungry again. So we have dinner. Sometimes I'll eat dinner at home or I'll go out with friends. And one of my favorite things to eat is lettuce cups. And of course, lots of water.
What? No rice, no pasta, no potatoes, no fun, as far as I'm concerned. And that meal is only 236 calories. I want to eat big at dinner time. I don't want to restrict my calories to 200. And the protein, 30 grams, a whopping 30 grams for that small amount of calories. That is huge and not good for the liver, the kidneys, the skin, and health in general. As you may notice, Cassie is having a lot of water during the day, and whether it's to do with the fact that she's having a low carb diet and quite dehydrated from it, or because it's a dieting method, because it is a very common dieting method to have a lot of water to fill up your stomach so then you don't want to eat as much. It's another form of calorie restriction, which is really dangerous. You know, any sort of calorie restriction is going to lead you to binging and to weight gain long term.
If I am hungry, which oftentimes I am, I mean, who doesn't like to eat? I may need a snack. So one of my favorite snacks, or you know, past dinner desserts, is actually Quest Cookie. It is seriously so easy to make. It is ridiculous and it tastes like a real cookie.
So these bodybuilder bars are really in vogue at the moment. If you want to bulk up, if you want to look like a bodybuilder or begin to look like a bodybuilder, then sure, go for these high protein, low carb bars because that's what they do.
If I am hungry, which oftentimes I am, I'm kind of hungry. I get hungry again. I'm kind of hungry.
Cassie is predictably hungry throughout the day because she's hardly eating anything and she's having low carbs, so she's not satisfied. So she's always thinking about food and she's using discipline not to eat, which is a typical dieting deprivation model, which we want to get away from, right, girls?
So guys, that's basically what I eat in a day. Changes from time to time, but usually it's very high protein and it's low carb. And if I am training for something, I definitely go super low carb.
Okay, so this statement has me completely baffled. If I'm training for something, I go super low carb. That is actually the opposite of what you want to do because all your cells are fueled on sugar, on glucose. So you need to have a high carb diet. If you're training for something specific, unless you want to fall flat on your face and do really poorly, you keep the carbs high. There's no long-term athletes who are low carb. And it's like, you know, going for a bike ride and taking out the air from your tires and trying to ride your bike. It's just that much harder and you don't want to do it. You don't want to exercise. So you got to keep the carbs up. You got to keep stoking that fire with the carbohydrates. Stoke your metabolism. Don't starve yourself. Don't deprive yourself of your brain and body's number one fuel source, which is glucose. Okay, so it took a moment to put Cassie's stats into a BMR calculator. So she's about 130 or more pounds. She's 5'5" and a half, which is actually the same height as me, and she does about moderate exercise. So this is a rough estimation, but basically she needs 1400 calories to just survive. So that's if you're doing absolutely nothing and you're just sleeping in bed all day. She needs 1400 calories just for that. And we all know she's doing a heck of a lot more than just sleeping all day. So let's have a look at how many calories she's consuming. So I punched in Cassie's numbers into Chronometer and I came up with this total, which is 1,388. And I was actually being generous in a few areas. So I'm thinking it's even less calories than this. And she's got 54 grams of fat, protein 101 grams, carbohydrates a measly 160 grams per day. So eating this little teaches the brain to store fat on the body in case there is a famine coming up, because it's like the body is in a famine, so it's holding onto this weight and it's slowing the metabolism down, you know, conserving energy because the brain is thinking, oh, we are in starvation mode. We need to hold on to as much energy, as much fat on our body in case there's going to be that famine later on. The body will also start to eat up its own muscle mass. So you do not want to put yourself into this state. So you want to teach your body to become a fat burner. And so this isn't the way to do it. This is just slowing that metabolism down big time. So with those kind of high protein, high fat stats, Cassie is going to be storing around a pound of animal fat on her body per week. And that's how these high protein bulking diets work. As you can see, Cassie is actually, if you go to the calories, the yellow calorie bar there, Cassie's actually having 50% less calories than what I'm averaging per day. I have between 25 and 3,500 calories. And, you know, I'm actually maintaining my slim, fit physique. I'm about 115 pounds and it's no problem at all. It's easy peasy and I'm eating a high carb, high calorie diet. And that's what works long term. You know, these quick fix kind of high protein diets, you may lose water weight initially, but that's just due to you losing a lot of water out of your muscles atrophying, because muscles are about 80% water. So when you stop having carbohydrates, you dehydrate the body, the water is sucked out of the muscles start to atrophy, and you just kind of shrink like a prune. It's not a lot of fat loss, it's a lot of water loss, which is only temporary. And then the weight comes back, you teach your body to be a fat storer, your metabolism slows, it's a whole big mess. Do not do it. Do not do high protein diets. Just on a side note, the standard recommendation for a 9 to 13 year old girl is 14 to 2200 calories per day. So Cassie's actually getting under that of what a 9 to 13 year old needs, and actually younger than that, she's having less calories. So that is severely impairing her metabolism and her ability to burn fat. Fat burns in the flame of carbohydrates, so you need to have enough coming in to actually burn fat efficiently and long term. And she's also risking severe vitamin and mineral deficiency, and all the acid that's circulating in her blood from the high protein is putting herself at risk of osteoporosis, liver and kidney issues, to name a few. And eating less than 2100 calories is actually considered to be in a famine according to the World Health Organization. So don't put yourself into a famine. It's not only making your body acidic, but it's turning into a fat storer. It's not making you efficient or happy. Okay, Cassie, so I just want to show you what a ripe banana looks like. Number 7 is ripe. Number 1 to 6 are not ripe. They have raw starch that hasn't converted to sugar. And raw starch can be really tough on digestion, can cause constipation. So you really got to wait till they're ripe and spotty. So Cassie, I recommend you give this lifestyle, the raw to 4 lifestyle, a go, because it really does work and it's going to make you feel and look your best long term, because you get to eat carbs. Everybody loves carbs. You get to eat unlimited. You don't need to restrict your calories anymore. All this luscious fruit, you can eat potatoes, you can eat rice and pasta, and you don't have to, you know, starve yourself for weight loss. Long term results are what matters, not these quick fixes, these, you know, yo-yo diets. Kick them to the curb. It's time for a healthy long-term lifestyle that you can sustain the rest of your life. Here are some other raw to fours who you may know.
Hey guys, welcome back to another video. Today I'm going to be updating you guys on my raw vegan lifestyle. For those of you who are new to my channel, I follow a vegan plant-based diet, which is very high raw. I'll get a bit more into that. And this lifestyle is called Raw Till 4. It was created by Fuli the Banana Girl here on YouTube. She is awesome. She has lots of great advice on health, and she has some very inspirational and motivational videos.
Then I found this really cool diet called Raw Till 4, which was created by Fuli the Banana Girl here on YouTube, and she is one of my biggest inspirations ever. And basically, I eat raw fruits and veggies all day and then have a warm vegan meal at night. So if you want to start getting healthy, I recommend giving your fridge a makeover. Try eliminating all dairy and high-fat prefab foods, replace soda with fruit juice, replace milk with soy almond or coconut milk, and stock your fridge full of fresh fruits and veggies.
If for some of you who are not familiar with a raw till 4, it is where you eat raw fruits and vegetables throughout the day until 4 p.m. After 4 p.m. you can eat, it is optional to you if you want to eat cooked food. Well, the whole point of the raw till 4 is that you can't eat cooked food.
I've only been doing it 5 weeks and I already feel so amazing. It's just incredible how different your body can feel after doing this plant-based diet. And also Fuli the Banana Girl, oh my god, I found her YouTube channel the other day and I spent about 3 hours just watching videos back to back.
Okay, Fruit Bat, so I hope you have a great weekend. Don't forget to go fruit or root yourself. And if you found this video helpful, give us a thumbs up. And I will see you fresh and fruity on Monday.